Backstabbing authorities just began confiscating guns for insane reason, met with all-out war. The crackdown on gun control had come to a screeching halt once Donald Trump took office, but that didn't stop Democrats from getting their way. Without warning, gun owners are now waking up to horrible news about their Second Amendment right, which has just been incredibly infringed upon in a way that's beyond unconstitutional. To control people's right to their own safety and property is at the top of liberals' list of what's most important to them to regain some semblance of power. As such, they find any and every loophole they can to usurp citizens' rights that they don't like. Sneaky liberals plotted against Republicans and surprised everyone with what they were able to pass through the night, forcing law-abiding Americans into confiscation or face jail time. The old saying goes that nothing good happens after midnight, and that's certainly the case as people law-abiding gun owners in Hawaii are getting bad news about their guns that they are going to have to give up for the most asinine reason yet. The tyrannical leadership in this state has just officially made weapons confiscation a reality for those who legally and rightfully purchased their guns. The Daily Caller reports. Hawaiian authorities have asked medical marijuana users to voluntarily surrender firearms due to their medicinal status. This may mark the first time a law enforcement entity has moved to confiscate guns from cannabis patients. Marijuana users in Honolulu are expected to turn over all firearms and ammunition to the state within 30 days of receiving the notice, according to a letter signed by Police Chief Susan Ballard, reported the website Leafly. The state's first medical marijuana dispensary opened in August, but federal law prevents patients who ingest cannabis from owning a firearm. Marijuana is still categorized as a Schedule I drug by the government and is considered in the same league as ecstasy and heroin. 29 states and Washington, D.C., have passed laws to legalize cannabis for medical or recreational use, but the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms, ATF, issued a letter in 2011 saying there will be no exceptions for weed users with regard to gun ownership. The agency stated, "Any person who uses or is addicted to marijuana, regardless of whether his or her state has passed legislation authorizing marijuana use for medicinal purposes, is an unlawful user of or addicted to a controlled substance, and is prohibited by federal law from possessing firearms and ammunition." ATF. The Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals heard arguments in September 2016 against laws prohibiting medical marijuana patients from owning a gun, but unanimously ruled in favor of the government. The restrictions did not infringe upon patients' Second Amendment rights because cannabis was found to cause irrational or unpredictable behavior, the panel said. This new wave of unconstitutional control comes after the liberal state of Oregon created a different way to force legal gun owners to forfeit their weapons or face jail time. Second Amendment watchdogs at 2A News explains the bill and the government's gross overreach. On Wednesday, Oregon Governor Kate Brown signed into law a Democrat-sponsored gun confiscation bill, permitting Oregon judges to order guns to be confiscated under an extreme risk protection order, based on hearsay evidence, and before the gun owner is permitted a hearing to challenge the order. The law is based on Oregon Senate Bill 719 and was passed by Oregon Democrats despite widespread condemnation by constitutional scholars and gun rights groups. All but four Democratic senators voted in favor of the bill, while every Republican senator but one voted against the bill. The sole token Republican voting for the bill, Senator Brian Boquist, R. Dallas, Oregon, claimed the law would reduce veteran suicides, and it was under that noble-sounding purpose that Democrat legislators steamrolled the bill through the legislative process. Paul Phillips, president of Oregon Gun Owners, noted the hypocrisy and the underlying purpose of the bill. The bill, he says, will do little to prevent suicides. What it will actually do, under the guise of suicide prevention, is deprive Oregon gun owners of their legal rights under the Second Amendment. Gun confiscations, he says, will be based on hearsay evidence alone, and the firearm owner is not, even, privy to a fair trial. This is liberals' systematic and sneaky approach to total and complete gun control. If they take this right away step by step and piece by piece, as seems to be the case, It won't be long before this right granted Americans in the Constitution is totally erased. Democrats will do absolutely everything they can to disarm Americans and won't stop until they have made a sitting duck out of every citizen in this country.